Did you guys know Microsoft actually had a to-do list app? I've talked about it before, but I feel like nobody really cares about Microsoft To-Do. But it versus ToDoIst is something I want to dive into, so let's get right into it. So looking at Microsoft To-Do, it's a free application that I actually utilized at my work for a long time. I used it for about 3 or 4 months before I switched to anything else. And it actually works really well. It's a free application that can be used as a great daily planner and task management system. It works great on the computer, whether that be Mac or desktop. It works well on my iPhone that I've utilized it in, and it has the capability to go on tablets as well. So I like this application if you want to go completely free, but there is also a lot of free capabilities that happen with Todoist. And the difference here is that Microsoft To-Do is completely free. You get everything that goes with it, but with Todoist, you only have a limit of a few projects, a couple filters, and only 1 week of activity history. So if you're trying to go and look back at what you've done before, I don't think free Todoist is the option, but the pro version is only $3 a month, and you get a really large bang for your buck for only $3. So one thing I want to showcase that you can do in Todoist that you really can't in Microsoft To-Do is I press A here, and oh my God, I have a keyboard shortcut system and I have natural language processing. So if I want to make a task happen at 9 a.m. tomorrow and then make it a priority one and then hashtag it and add it to a certain project, so work, and then add it and tag it with work. I can do all of that just by typing in there. And then if I press Control Enter, I got a task showing already. Really easy, really quick, made that happen. So if I then go to the upcoming section, you'll see that for tomorrow, there's this make a task happen here. And then something really cool is there's an integration with Google Calendar, so that if I go here, you can see there's actually a couple of tests here that I made for an example for another video. But basically what happens is it can integrate easily with Google Calendar so that it can take up the different time slots on your Google Calendar. So what can Microsoft To-Do in comparison to this? It has a nice format. It can do a lot of the things that Todoist can do, from, you know, just like assigning due dates, having reminders, all those sort of things, but it can do a lot of things for free. So like in Todoist, for the free version, you wouldn't be able to set a reminder, but for free, you can do reminders in Microsoft To-Do. There are recurring tasks that can happen. You can have a recur every sort of, well, how many weeks, whatever, how many days, daily, weekly, monthly, bi-weekly, and you can attach files, and you can do a lot of things. Like, you have the full reign of this application for free, but the full reign of this application is less than what you have with Todoist. I personally think that this system that they actually have regarding the lists are actually pretty good. Like, this is what I used to do. I used to make recurring tasks and organize what I had like this in Microsoft To-Do at work, and it actually works pretty well. And they've added natural language processing to Microsoft To-Do recently. So as you'll see in this example, pay utilities bill by Friday at 6 a.m. So it actually added natural language processing, which is a step up from what it used to have when I worked with it. And the nice thing about this is it actually has reminders and due dates in Microsoft To-Do for free, so it is a competitor to Todoist, unlike where previous updates for this application, it wasn't. And this can interact with the Microsoft ecosystem extremely well, and you can add assignees to people who are in your system. You can actually import things from Outlook email onto your task management system, but I will say this, the Google ecosystem that can interact with Todoist is a little bit better, and it doesn't have keyboard shortcuts in the same way, in my opinion, that Todoist does. But if you're looking for a really solid free option, Microsoft To-Do might be for you. Something that I really like in Microsoft To-Do is actually the changing this to add to my day. So the nice thing about this is the fact that it adds it to my day, whether it was actually completed or not. So even if the due date also isn't on this exact day, it's different, because like, we all know that we have gone overdue on due dates, but you know, sometimes I still need to do the thing that was already due. Like, rather than moving the due date, it just would be a part of my day in Microsoft To-Do. And I think that works well. Now, something that doesn't work well in Microsoft To-Do is the adding of labels and the priority system that Todoist has, as well as the level of integrations. If you want to integrate Microsoft To-Do with anything, You're basically stuck with Outlook. But when it comes to ToDoIst, I have it connected with pretty much any daily planner app that's out there. There's AkiFlow, Friday, Sensamo. There's even a integration with Twist, which is the sort of sister application to ToDoIst, which is a chat application. Now, Microsoft To-Do can be seen as a intermediary sort of situation for Microsoft Loop. I think when Microsoft Loop comes out, we're gonna see that Microsoft really starts leveling up its project and task management game. But for now, this doesn't really have many integrations. It's a little bit more clunky looking. I think ToDoIst looks better and has a better feel overall. But my verdict is, if you're in the Outlook ecosystem and you're at your job, use Microsoft To-Do for yourself. It really worked for me for months, and I think I did okay at my job during that time. But if you have the Google ecosystem and you have a at-home situation where you want to spend a few bucks on a productivity app for task management, go with ToDoIst. You will have one last thing in the coffin that I think is big. You have more visualizations. Like if I go here, it's nice to have priority. It's nice to have a list versus a board view. It's nice to have grouping. All those sort of different visualizations are really what makes ToDoIst step one part ahead of Microsoft To-Do and worth the $3 a month, in my opinion. If you like this video and want to see more on how to improve your productivity, check this one out. You're going to be really productive.